installment of Views from an Old Polish Perspective. Well, during the week, we heard the news of Jamaal Bowman. What did he do? He pulled the fire alarm to stop a vote in Congress, in the House of Representatives, to okay spending for another 45 days for, I don't know what it was. However much money they spend in 45 days. Anyway, he didn't like it, and he pulled the fire alarm, and then he's in the news. So you got to ask yourself the question, who is Jamaal Bowman? Well, we're going to take a look at that today, because obviously there's a couple other videos on the internet explaining who Jamaal Bowman is. So his first thought was, of course, he's going to blame Trump. You know, that's what Democrats do. They blame Trump for everything. And then, of course, AOC goes to his rescue with a novel idea on why he may have pulled that fire alarm. Anyway, we're going to take a look. Jamaal Anthony Bowman, born April 1st, 1976. Well, you know, born April Fool's Day, but you know, my dad was born on April Fool's Day, but he served 38 years in the Army, and he served under General George Patton in World War II. So, you know, just don't take that April 1st into anything. Okay, Bowman is the founder and former principal of Cornerstone Academy for Social Action. Sounds like a communist school. Now, how did this guy become the principal? He started his own school. Where did he get the money from? I'm not sure. Okay, and he's also a member of the Democrat Socialists of America. Okay, Bowman is a member of the Squad, a faction of progressive House Democrats. So, how much more do we got to find out about this Jamaal Bowman? Okay, he's a member of the Squad, and we all know who they are. And, of course, you know, a couple of days after he pulled the fire alarm, he said he pulled the fire alarm because Republicans are Nazis. Yeah, real bright. You know, that's the best these people could come up with. These are the greatest minds that are supposed to lead the world. Okay. So, I guess they never read a history book, because if you compare what they believe with Hitler and Mein Kampf and all the other stuff, I mean, they're trying to bring in socialism just like Hitler did. And they call other people Nazis. So figure that one out. Okay, early life and education. Bowman was born in Manhattan, New York. He lived with his grandmother in the East River houses in East Harlem during the week, and with his mother and sisters in Yorkville on weekends. His grandmother died when he was 8 years old. At age 16, he moved with his family to Surville, New Jersey. So basically, you know, this covers his early life. I'm not going to make a comment, but I should. Bowman is a fan of New York hip-hop group Wu-Tang Clan. He described hip-hop as a culture that is created by teenagers who were forgotten about, and because they were forgotten about, they were forced to come together and create something beautiful. Bowman drew inspiration from Wu-Tang Clan during his underdog campaign, and has frequently been seen with Wu-Tang Clan embezzled face covering the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so with all this, Bowman sent a message to the voters. So we're going to take a look at this inspiration, Bowman's inspiration, Wu-Tang Clan, with a couple of short videos here.
I grew up on the crime scene. side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job at second hands. Moms bounced on old men. So then we moved to Shaolin land. A young youth, you're rocking the gold tooth. Low goose, only way I begin to G-York was drug loot. And let's start it like this, son. Bowling with this one and that one. Pulling out gats for fun. But it was just a dream for the team who was a fiend. Started smoking wools at 16 and running up in.
Just consider the unparalleled advantage of a natural disaster that's impossible to manage.
Good chance, niggas counterfeit the funk. I smoke the beat of the skunk, tree top of the trunk. Moonshine drunk, get monk, yeah, get shrunk. The judge is stunk, I be fucking bitches by the dunk. My name Black, you birds wanna play in my dirt? Bitch, stop my mama, sir, free lunch from the church. I come like a thousand doves. Bitch, you quiet at the bus, making the fuss. I got self-love.
And carry like Mariah. I come from the Shaolin slum, and the alley I'm from is coming through with nothing. Enough guns, so if you wanna come sweating, stressing, contesting, you got your soft swords at the midsection. Don't talk the talk, if you can't walk the walk, phony the outline the talk. I'm mad vexed, is what the projects make me. Rebel to the grain, there's no way to barricade me. Steamroller niggas like an 18.
Even if it was all so simple.
Yo. Started off on an island, AK Shaolin, brothers wailing, gunshots thrown the phone down. Back in the days, I'm eight now, making a tape now. Ray gotta get a plate now. Ignorant and mad young, wanted to be the one till I got blah, blah, blah. Yeah, my pops was a fiend since 16, shooting that in his bloodstream. That's the life of a crimey, real life crimey, and others know the habits behind me. Day one, yo, growing all up in the ghetto, now I'm a with.
Back to you to that, but you got to get a kind of a background on the influences in Jamaal Bowman's life and what shapes his life. We live in America and everybody's free to listen to any kind of music they want. You know, there's no problem with that. None of us have a problem with that. But when they take that lifestyle and try to force it upon everyone in the United States, we got a problem with that. You can see the lifestyle and everything from the music, and if that influences Jamaal Bowman, that's one thing. You know, it's not the type of person we should have in Congress. But when Jamaal Bowman and the rest of the squad believes that that lifestyle is what should guide the United States. And we know socialists, they take their beliefs, they take whatever they're into, and socialists want to force that lifestyle onto everyone, force it onto everyone. So that's appears to be where we're at right now. Are they forcing that on us? Well, you know, take a look at what they're saying and what they're doing and their exaggerations, and they believe in an open border and they believe in abortion. Everyone should be able to have an abortion whenever they want to, and you know, they're not doing anything about the drugs or the firearms and weapons coming across, and all the criminals coming across. As a matter of fact, they're welcoming the criminals coming across the border with open arms. They're behind all of this stuff. So are we seeing something and learning something about Jamaal Bowman and what he's trying to force the United States into? Well, let's take a look at the Democratic Socialists of America, the party that he's a member of, and see what it is. It's a multi-tenancy Democrat Socialist and labor-orientated political organization in the United States. Well, its roots are in the Socialist Party of America. And then here you got the leaders. You can look them up, do some more research on your own. But basically, socialist and communist. In the 1960s, and former members of socialist and communist parties of the old left, upon the DSA's founding, Harrington and the Socialist feminist author Barbara Enkright were elected co-chairs of the organization. So let's take a look at what else they're into. Though the DSA is not a political party. So many organizations, members in Congress have initiated various pieces of legislation central to the modern progressive movement in the United States, including Medicare for All Act and the Green New Deal. So they're into Medicare for All and the Green New Deal along with a whole bunch of stuff. Now they just mentioned a couple of names here, AOC and Rashida Tlaib were elected to the House in November 2020. And then you also got Cori Bush and Jamaal Bowman listed here. As of July 2023, 51 state lawmakers and 132 local officials were affiliated with the DSA. What else we got on the DSA? On June 26, 2018, DSA member and endorsed AOC won the Democratic primary. Leader Nancy Pelosi dismissed the win as not to be viewed as something that stands for anything else and said it represented change only in one progressive district. Well, you know, take a look at who came out and who defended Jamaal Bowman when he pulled that fire alarm. It was the top Democrats. You know, put it all together and what do we got? In the 2020 elections, at least 36 DSA members won office, earning more than 3.1 million votes. So they still are a small minority. Remember, Trump got 80 million votes. They got 3.1 million. And most of these people are just, I don't know why they voted for him. And how many votes did they put in there from, mail-in ballots? Okay, let's take a look at their membership. In 2015, 6,200 members. We go up to 2021, they hit a high of 95,000 members. In 2022, 83,000. And in 2023, 78,000. So they've been basically shrinking from a large increase up to 2021. So this is a shrinking, they're a dying political group, but, you know, they're still around. They're still, look at how much of the press and how much of the left media and how much they're getting attention on social media, TikTok, Facebook, and everything else. They're a small minority. 78,000 people are getting, 900% of the attention in the press. So, here's Bowman. He calls everyone Republicans are Nazis. And, you know, ask him about his father. Did his father fight in World War II? We got to ask these questions. We got to find out what's going on, who else is involved. There's other Democrat leaders we really should take a look into and find out exactly how they are affiliated. And as we can see today, you know what? We're seeing the vast majority of Democrats are leaning over towards socialism. So there you have it. There's views from an old Polish perspective. You know, I mean, you got to know one thing about Polish people. For 600 years, they've been enslaved by one country after another, every generation over that 600-year period. And you know what? Poles cannot stand communist or socialist or anything. They have a view of the ultimate democracy that they tried to explain, Kosciuszko and Pulaski tried to explain it, and they worked a lot of it, their views of the perfect republic, into the Constitution. So there you have it. Don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, share, subscribe, and let's keep up. Let's get out the information on what these people actually stand for. Have a great day.